Today we are going to visit Q158. This is one of the most famous Parinirvana cave. There are two inscriptions on the north wall of the corridor. One is clear, 大波馆内三学法师持波僧仪. 大波 means Tubo. Dunhuang was ruled by Tubo from 781 to 848. So this cave was excavated by the Tibetan sponsor. They believed in the Vajrayana form of the Buddhism, which is often called esoteric Buddhism. During this period, more than 40 caves were built, so we can find exquisite caves during this period. This cave has a rectangular main chamber with a coffin-shaped ceiling. Pure Land murals were painted on it. The Nirvana cave was often designed as a reclining in shape. There was an altar built against the wall, and the main anchor of this cave was the reclining Buddha. Shakyamuni was lying on his right side. We can find the Shakyamuni Buddha rest his head on his right hand, and the left hand rest on his body. The Buddha has wavy hair, half-open eyes, and the closed mouth. These features imply that this is a release from karma, samsara, rebirth, and as well as the dissolution of skandhas. The Nirvana Buddha was lying on his right side, and we can find as if he was in the frontal position. The articulation folds of the Kashyapa are very stylized. This is a feature to identify this figure as the Shakyamuni Buddha. The entire image bespeaks the realm of enduring the spiritual tranquility. The pillow of the reclining Buddha is decorated with brocaded motif, comprising birds enclosed in floral rondos on the red background. This motif is identical to many examples of the brocaded bird motif unearthed in Qinghai province, and it is similar in style to the brocaded bird motif depicted on the murals at Kizil Cave in Xinjiang. This cave was constructed in the period when the Hush Corridor was under Tibetan rule. Decorative motifs with Sasanian rondos were popular around the Dunhuang region. The pillow offers a fine example of this kind of influence. Under the platform appeared five musicians and dancers who are considered as the Malas. Mala was an ancient Indian republic that constitute one of the 16 Mahajanapadas of ancient India. The republic is notable for being the chosen death place for Gautama Buddha. After his death, the Malas wanted to keep his Sarira, but the other kingdom, also wanting their part, went to war and besieged the city of Kushinagala. Finally, an agreement was reached, and the Buddha's cremation relics were divided among 8 royal families and his disciples. The first one stepped upside down with both hands touching the ground. The second figure bent his left leg and played the flute. Beside him is the one who played the drum. The fourth person is singing aloud with his right hand stretched out. The fifth one holds a whisk in his left hand and dances happily. On the other side of the platform is Subhadla, who is the last person converted by the Buddha before he passed into Parinirvana. According to some accounts, he was a 120-year-old Brahmana. He went to see the Buddha who ordained him. Subhadla felt that he was unworthy to witness the passage of the Buddha into Parinirvana and thus asked the Buddha for permission to die first. So he set him on fire in deep meditation.
The most representative mural of this cave are the Bodhisattva and Arhats behind the reclining Buddha. The morning scene of Arhats were painted on the south wall, and we can find the Kashyapa was in the center. He was embraced by two disciples in order to prevent him falling down. The facial expression of the Bodhisattva and Arhats are completely different. The Bodhisattva shows expression. This part is the morning princes from various kingdoms. Because this cave was built in the Tibetan period, so the first figure was a Tibetan king. Beside him is the Han Chinese emperor, who were escorted by two court ladies. The other figures are from Central Asian princes, some severing their ears and nose, and some even stab their chest with knives. The practice of self-mutilation originated from Central Asia. Even the tradition lasted for today. On the upper section of the north wall, we can find a lady jumped out of the bed. Terrified by the news, she descended from heaven.
Cave 158 is one of the represented caves in the Mogao grottoes during the Middle Tang Dynasty. There are precious and scarce murals to show different costumers and funerary customers. This cave focuses on the theme, Nirvana. It is difficult for everyone to be unimpressed by its artistic achievement.